for the land of the free and the home of the brave.
The woman kneeling here is American women's soccer star Megan Rapinoe. Because of America's flaws, she chooses to protest the singing of the national anthem. Recently, a fencer at the Pan American Games likewise took a knee to the Star Spangled Banner.
Fencer Race Imboden taking a knee on the podium during the anthem after winning gold in the team foil event on Friday.
These protests against the national anthem were popularized a few years ago by former San Francisco 49ers quarterback Colin Kaepernick, who has now become the spokesman for Nike.
He has become wealthy through professional sports. He should be grateful for the opportunity to play hard and entertain people, and to show disrespect for the nation seemed inappropriate. Well, I think keeping politics out of sports is probably a wise thing. I mean, one of the problems we suffer from in America is that we've politicized everything.
It really is incredible, and especially now that we've seen this controversy with the NBA and a lot of these athletes and figures who say they were so much a part of it, you know, they talk about social justice, things like that, now being unwilling to criticize an actual authoritarian regime, an actual police state. That basically, I mean, look, there's some terrible things that go on in communist China because the league has a lot of business interests there. Nike, this organization has a lot of, they make a lot of money off of a Chinese market. And it's quite incredible. We see, you know, figures like Colin Kaepernick who will kneel for the U.S. national anthem. What do they have to say about communist China when it comes to those kind of issues? Suddenly they're silent, they're quiet about these things.
Basketball star LeBron James supports Colin Kaepernick, whom he calls Cap, and Cap's protests of the national anthem.
I stand with Cap. I kneel with Cap.
Yet LeBron James condemns those who have expressed solidarity with the Hong Kong protesters who are speaking out in the face of Chinese oppression. Interestingly, many of the Hong Kong protesters have waved American flags while these high-paid athletes show a type of contempt for that very same flag.
As an immigrant to this amazing country of ours, I am appalled, I am disgusted, I am insulted to watch the way people are treating our flag and our national anthem right now. America is being transformed before our very eyes. The flag that once flew on every street corner in the United States is now considered a hate symbol on college campuses. Athletes who used to stand up with pride at the singing of the national anthem are now kneeling in protest. The world is turned upside down. When, before I came to the United States, when I was living in a bomb shelter in Lebanon, somebody had given me an American flag, a small American flag that I kept under my pillow. And that flag got me through my days in the bomb shelter, hoping that one day I will come to America. Today we have people complaining about the Betsy Ross flag, and they are complaining about our patriotism, despite the fact that President Obama himself had no problem having that flag draped behind him. It's a part of who we are. It's a part of our history. You cannot erase our history. You know, every nation, like every human being, we have done things in our past that we are not proud of. There were things in our past that were not perfect. What makes nations great is they learn from experience.
There are people who will take things out of historical context, promote them to serve their present day agenda, and this whole distortion of American history. Lincoln once said that we were not a perfect union, but we were a perfectible union, which meant that has America throughout the course of its history had stumbles? Yes. But we as a self-governing people, you know, based on the biblical truths and seeds that have been planted in our great legal framework, we've been able to correct those wrongs. Yeah, we had slavery. We can't avoid saying that slavery was once here in this country. But just think, in less than 240 years, we went from the institution of slavery being in place in this country to Barack Obama being elected president of the United States. You know, no other country has in fact made that much progress in that short a time.
There are a lot of Americans who I think were upset and agitated at individuals like Colin Kaepernick and getting rid of the Betsy Ross flag, which I think is ridiculous. You know, can these same people be critical of a terrible authoritarian regime that is committing atrocities right now? You know, a lot of these people are not. And I think a lot of people see through that is these people are just using hollow, what people call virtue signaling. You know, they're taking these things, these steps that they're praised as being so brave of standing up to America at the same, in a free country, yet when actual consequences are coming down the line, they may lose a lot of money, they may get criticism from their league, suddenly they're dead silent. And I think that hypocrisy, I think that really stands out.
Betsy Ross of Philadelphia is credited with being the first to design the American flag. But today, somehow that Betsy Ross flag is viewed by some as a racist symbol.
The idea that Betsy Ross is somehow a racist person or a symbol is absolutely absurd.
During the summer of 2019, Colin Kaepernick spoke out against the Betsy Ross flag appearing on some sneakers because he said she and her flag stood for racism. So Nike, in a bow to political correctness, pulled those shoes.
And I think that that decision by Nike, again, it's absurd, especially when you consider, you know, Nike is willing to do business with Chinese communists, people like this, where you do have terrible things that have taken place in that country, and yet we're going after the Betsy Ross flag, which is a symbol for the United States of America, for freedom, for independence, for this person who was at one time very much celebrated in this country. We can't celebrate this person. And I think that it only highlights the absurdity of these attacks on America.
Unfortunately, America, partially because of free speech, we've seen a proliferation of protest. Protest is important, it's protected, but now it's time for more unity.